Okay, now speaking to Brian yesterday, and he said that basically back in the day when you were both racing together, that, well, Cav's a second, an imitation of you, basically.
A poor imitation, is this what you're trying to say?
Exactly, yeah.
Well, I'm flattered that you might say that, really am, but Brian speaks highly of me, I understand, and I speak highly of Brian, so...
Which is understandable.
We go back a long way, so it's nice to see him here again, and with the magnificent charge of Mark Cavendish that he has underneath him, so...
When you were racing, there wasn't large British teams, was there? You rode for
ANC
Alfreds. There we are, memory. And they got a last minute invitation to the tour, stuff like that. And with Sky now and a few of the big British squads, like Node 4, for instance, as well. Could you have imagined back then British cycling being what it is now?
I guess not, no. I mean, there's been a lot of things that I could never have imagined. A British world champion, a British Tour de France winner, 2 years running now. I mean, who could have ever imagined that? No, it's
just the amount of English in the peloton as well, language.
I feel blessed that I'm still kind of involved in the sport and I'm around to see it now. It really is something that I'm very proud of and continue to be every day.
Like Brian Holm, you must be in it purely because you love the sport.
Yeah, it's what I know. It's what I know, and some things about it are better than others. But I wouldn't want to be doing anything else.
If you won't, Brian was saying before he was a bike rider, he couldn't have gone to university. He was going to be a bricklayer. What would have it been for you if you hadn't turned to the bike?
Dread to think, I really do dread to think. I shudder to think.
Okay, yeah. Thank you for your time and good luck with the day.
Thanks.
Cheers.
Thank you.